Good afternoon. Today is March 6, 2017, and this is the little room of yours truly, Arthur Denchfield, also known as Arcturus Rex on Twitter and Facebook. And on Facebook, I'm ArthurDenchfield.9. Anyway, in front of us is a statue of Our Lady Fatima, and above the statue of Our Lady Fatima is the holy face of the Holy Shroud of Turin of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. At the very moment of his holy resurrection almost 2,000 years ago, his physiognomy was etched on the Holy Shroud the moment he came back to life. So this is photographic proof of the holy resurrection of Jesus Christ, Lord of Lords, King of Kings, Priest of Priests, Prophet of Prophets. And to the right is a color photo of the International Pilgrim Virgin Statue of Our Lady Fatima that wept in New Orleans in 1972, and that was taken in Sao Paulo in 1973 in the presence of two imperial royal princes who are descendants of King St. Louis IX and descendants also of Holy Roman Emperor Charlemagne, whose etching is over there on the left side on top of our total gem, and an astrolabe for all the stars and constellations above him. Anyway, to the left is a painting of St. Michael the Archangel, which is available from AmericanNeedsFatima.org. And we salute St. Michael. And we had a special prayer that we said to Our Lady a few days ago, and we asked for the great favor of spending our eternity after we pass on until the end of the world as a human assistant of St. Michael the Archangel. After we do our time in purgatory, we cannot think of a more noble or elevated post or assignment than to be the sidekick of St. Michael the Archangel from the human race. And we ask Almighty God to allow us to do this. And I ask Our Lady to intercede for this request. Today is my birthday. Yes. This is a happy birthday card I got. Very nice card from dear friends of mine. Today I turned 75 years old. And today is also the birthday of a dear friend of mine who's a senior member of the Brazilian Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property. And he's been living in Europe, representing all the TFPs for many decades. And here is his picture right here. That's yours truly, and that's Mr. Nelson Fragelli. Excuse me. This is an article that appeared in the Miami News. And it says, Conservative Catholic forms group here. And the date of this article from the Miami News, written by Bob Wilcox way back when, is July 22nd, 1972. And it's a very interesting article here. And perhaps I should read it, perhaps I should not. At any rate, it's probably too boring for me to read to you. But I wanted to say happy birthday to you, Mr. Nelson. Nelson Fragelli, he turned 74, and I turned 75 on March 6th. And he's the one, Nelson Rivera Fragelli, is the one that was responsible for me knowing about the Brazilian Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property way back in 1971. After I saw a video in December of 1971 about the Brazilian Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property, and how they were instrumental in mobilizing Brazilian public opinion against communism in general and against President João Goulart, communist president of Brazil in particular, and with the aid of the Rosary Campaign, Brazil was freed from communism in 1964 when the president took a plane and fled. And in 1973, the Chilean TFP counterpart of the Brazilian TFP had a great role in the defeat of communism in Chile. At any rate, another picture here, let me show you. Here's an article that appeared in the Miami Herald. This is yours truly. This is our picture from Parris Island, where we got, we became Lance Corporal, squad leader, Parris Island, and that was December of 1965. And let's see, once a playboy, he finds happiness in God, and it talks about my life in the early 70s. And there are a lot of things about in this article here with Mr. Nelson that are worthy of being read, but time is of the essence, and so we're just going to have to skip it and maybe write that or make a copy of that for Facebook. Again, going down Our Lady of Fatima, we have this black and white photos of the Little Flower and St. Charbel Macleod, patron saint of Lebanon. The miraculous photo of St. Charbel leans on the mulatto saint statue of the mulatto saint of Peru, St. Martin de Porres, whose name I took from mine, confirmation, May 1st, 1959. And the American flag is there. We are U.S. veteran. We proudly served in the United States Marine Corps Reserves for 6 years. And that the music are famous military marches. And of course, the golden lion rampant on a red field is not only the symbol of the Lion of the Tribe of Judah, the symbol of monarchy, that is the royalty and monarchy of Christ the King, but it's also the symbol of the autonomous societies for the defense of tradition, family, and property, known as TFP, and all the whole world. And I am privileged to have been one of the founding members of the American Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property, alongside with Mr. John Russell Spann, Mr. Philip Calder, Mr. John Hart, and Mr. Tim Allen Reese. Tim Allen Reese from San Pedro, California, and I met in Sao Paulo in March of 1972, and both of us made the consecration to Our Lady in the Reign of Mary chamber, the Reign of Mary seat of the TFP headquarters, in the presence of the chairman, the master chair, ceremonies, Plinio Correa Beda, and also in the presence of their two Imperial Royal Highnesses, Prince Louis and Prince Bertrand de Orléans Braganza. And we want to extend our condolences to Mr. John Russell Spann, who's 11 years older than I am. So if I'm 75, he's 86. And it just came to our attention today during a birthday breakfast that I had with Mr. Sergio De Paz at Denny's here in Coral Gables, and Mr. Philip Craig, blind friend of mine, that John Spann's son passed away today. He got notice, and so we extend to you, Mr. John, our deepest condolences for the passing of your son, and I'm sure that he's in good hands and that he'll be interceding for us soon. Amen. Requiescat in pace. And of course, below here is the globe. That cross is a huge cross from a rosary that I got in Brazil. And that huge cross is over South America on that map. And it's over the land of the Holy Cross. Yes, the land of the Holy Cross. Do you know what the name of that country is today? That country is called Brazil. Just a minute. That's the country of Brazil, and of course, the Holy Cross fathers, they founded University of Notre Dame du Lac in 1842, and that's the degree from which my father, Arthur Leighton Denchfield Jr., graduated in 1929. That's his degree there underneath the Sacred Heart of Jesus. And we want to show you something here. Underneath the seagull. Underneath the seagull is our Commander-in-Chief, Donald John Trump. God bless you, Mr. President. And these are the four living creatures of Ezekiel, which we've talked to you about on our Facebook page, ArthurDenchfield.9. And there, we also call the boys from Brazil, some people call this the four horsemen of the apocalypse. There was such a team in Notre Dame under Newton Rockne, where my dad, this is his degree, University of Notre Dame du Lac, Our Lady of the Lake, and the Holy Cross Fathers. They founded Notre Dame du Lac in 1842, and it was in the year 542 AD, 1300 years before that, that Our Lady of the Lake, Notre Dame du Lac, grabbed Excalibur, the sword of King Arthur, King Arthur's knight. There's a book about King Arthur and his knights by Pyle. King Arthur's loyal knight threw Excalibur into the lake after King Arthur died in 542, and Notre Dame du Lac caught that sword. And then all of a sudden, Notre Dame du Lac University was founded 1,300 years later by the Holy Cross Fathers, and somehow in a mysterious way, was the Excalibur spirit was given to my dad, and he was an Arthur, and my dad gave it to me, also an Arthur, and I bequeathed that sword to Donald John Trump through 306 electoral votes for the greater glory of God. We had a very pleasant breakfast. If it's your birthday, you can get a free breakfast at Denny's restaurant, and that's what I did. I took my blind friend, and we met Mr. Sergio DePaz at Denny's here in Coral Gables, and I had a wonderful breakfast, and we talked about old times. And I want to take this opportunity to salute my dear friend Nelson Ribeiro Fragelli on his 74th birthday. Feliz aniversario, Senhor Nelson! Que prazer falar com o senhor no seu aniversário. O senhor e eu nascemos no mesmo dia. We were born the same day, except for 1 year apart. I was born in 1942, and Nelson was born in 1943. And I personally believe if Almighty God wants the next pope to be a layman pope, that Mr. Nelson Ribeiro Fragelli would be the candidate of choice. He speaks fluent Italian, German, French, Spanish, Portuguese, and English. And he speaks Latin too. And he's been living in Europe now for many decades. And he knows the Italian people well. He knows the French people well as the Spanish and Portuguese people well. And he knows the Brazilians well, and he knows the Americans well as the British people and the Irish people. Anyway, today is a very interesting day. I've already told you about this before, about all the numerical coincidences that have to do with 3-6, March 6. March, who was born on March 6 besides Mr. Nelson Fragelli and myself? Well, there was a 7'2" tall basketball phenomenon known as Shaquille O'Neal. Happy birthday to you, Shaquille. Shaquille's about 30 years younger than me, I believe, or maybe 40 years younger. I'm 75, and he was born in the 80s. And then there's Lady Kiri Te Kanawa of New Zealand, an extraordinary opera singer who was born on March 6, 1944. And there was also an astronaut from Russia, Valentina something another, beautiful name, and she was one of the first female astronaut of the Soviet Union who went out and out of space, and it's her birthday today, and I believe she and I are the same age. She's 75 also, and happy birthday to you. Yani Gariu Paruski. I do not speak Russian. I'm sorry. I wish I could say happy birthday in Russian. Anyway, let's get back to what we were saying. This is the 100th anniversary of Our Lady of Fatima, 2017. Our Lady of Fatima appeared six times in 1917 and gave to the church and the world a formula for world peace. And part of that formula that was a request that she made of the church and all the Catholic faithful to have a devotion to her Immaculate Heart, to pray the rosary daily, and to offer up one's sacrifices, daily sacrifices, in union with Christ's sacrifice, in order to become more godly and help the mystical body of Christ, and so on and so forth. And a very important thing happened, and we talked about this before, and we will talk about this until it happens. Right here is an apparition, 1929, on June 13, 1929, in Tui, Spain. God the Father, God the Holy Spirit, and Jesus on the cross, and Our Lady, the Mother of Jesus, appeared to a Catholic nun in Tui, Spain, asking that the Holy Father, in union with all the bishops in the world, consecrate Russia to the Immaculate Heart of Mary, and that has yet to be done. And some 2.5 billion people have perished unnecessarily because of the disobedience of 8 popes, including Francis, whose papacy is very much in doubt. I personally believe that he is in violation of the teaching of St. Robert Bellarmine. St. Robert Bellarmine, Jesuit, doctor of the church, was born, let's see, 400 years before I was born. He was born in 1542. And he wrote that it was possible for a pope to enter into heresy. And if this happened, that pope automatically was excommunicated. He excommunicated himself. And that's part of the teaching of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. And when Francis I came out with that document called Amoris Laetitia, in which priests are encouraged to give Holy Communion to sinners, adulterers, people who have married, divorced, married many times, as long as their conscience is clear, it's okay for them to receive communion. That caused a reaction among many, and one of them happened to be Cardinal Burke and 3 other cardinals. They wrote a letter asking for clarification of Amoris Laetitia in writing. This is known as a dubia. And Francis never answered this in writing, as these cardinals justifiably expected to happen. And so we personally believe that Francis has entered into heresy and is no longer pope. And this is why the church is in a very precarious situation. And we want to remind you about some so-called coincidences that happened to do with March 6th again. 3-6, March 6th. General Joseph Dunford, 36th Commandant, United States Marine Corps, currently the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. We joined the Marine Corps in 1965 after having worked at the New York World's Fair for 6 months for General Motors, Pontiac Motor Division, as a contact man, after we had gotten our college degree from St. Joseph's College in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, in February of 1965. That was our first job out of college, to work for General Motors, Pontiac Motor Division. And after that, the World's Fair closed. We joined the Marines, and they assigned me in Parris Island to Platoon what? Platoon 3006. And my home address at that time was 3601 Durango Street, where my family lived from 1959 until the year 2000. And so God speaks through numbers, and the address that we had in Brazil when I grew up in the northeastern part of Brazil was 1206 Avenida Beira Mar, Boa Viagem, Recife, Pernambuco, Brasil. 1206 Avenida Beira Mar. The digits 1206, those digits appear in the book of Revelation, in the book of the Apocalypse, where it says that the Antichrist will rule for 1260 days, and he will be confronted with by Enoch and Elias for 1260 days. And Jesus Christ himself, his public ministry was 1,260 days long. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, his public ministry was 3.5 years, and that's 3 years and 6 months. 3.5 years is 3 years and 6 months. That's the first 3-6. The second 3-6 was the election of a layman to the papacy, Pope St. Fabian. St. Fabian was a farmer who came into Rome from outside to witness the papal elections, and he had no intention or agenda to become the pope, the next pope. He was there to admire the newly elected pope. And a dove appeared above his head, and the Italian people, ever so intuitive, they said, "You're the next pope, God wills it." And so by public acclamation, St. Fabian became the 10th pope of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church in the year 236. And I have a joke. This is a joke between me and Mr. Nelson Fragelli, and it's the following. Don't choose me as the first layman pope after St. Fabian, because I'm the first 36. You have to go to the second 36. Like 236 St. Fabian, the second 36 is the 36 that was born in 1943 and who's very well qualified to be the Holy Father of the Holy Catholic Church. He speaks all these languages. He's a very spiritual person. He's a disciple of St. Louis de Montfort's True Devotion Treatise. That St. Louis de Montfort, he lost that manuscript. And it was found 126 years later in what year? 1842, the same year that University of Notre Dame du Lac was founded by the Holy Cross Fathers. It's just amazing. And on it goes. Arcturus is a star. It's a star in the heavens. It's 100 times larger than our sun. And it's 36 light years away from us. Arcturus is the root name of Arthur. Arthur, King Arthur. I am not King Arthur, but King Arthur and I have a lot in common. He was born in 465, and I got my college degree in 1965, and I got my Marine Corps stripe in 1965 from Parris Island, my first stripe. And that's just one of many, many coincidences. King Arthur died in 542, and I was born in 1942. And then there's the coincidences with the number 5. I was born March 6, 1942 in Porto Alegre, Rio Grande do Sul, Brazil. And according to some documents that I've seen, the capital city of Porto Alegre, where I was born, the first people began joining there in the years around 1742. In other words, 200 years before my birth is where the city of my birth was founded. Officially, it was founded a couple of years later. But the first people who settled there, the settlement started in 1742. And what happened 1,000 years before the founding of Porto Alegre? That was the birthday of Holy Roman Emperor Charlemagne. Charlemagne was born in 742. What happened in 1242? On the day of my baptism, I was baptized April 5, 1942 at the Cathedral Mother of God, the Mother of God Cathedral, Our Lady Mother of God Cathedral in Porto Alegre on April 5, 1942. 700 years later, after exactly to the date that Russian Prince Alexander Nevsky defeated the Teutonic Knights in the Battle of the Ice. April 5, 1242. So, with God, it's all part of divine providence, and every one of us can come up, I think, with a similar tale of many things that seem to be coincidences when they're not. General Douglas MacArthur, he died on April 5, 1964. And he's the one in 1944 on the day of that famous picture of my dad and myself, or my mom and myself, and my brother and myself from Rio de Janeiro, we put this picture, 1944 picture, on the internet. That's the year that General Douglas MacArthur said, "I shall return." That's right. He left the Philippines and he promised the Filipinos, "I shall return." And he did return. He did return to save the Philippines from the Japanese. And we salute you, sir, General Douglas MacArthur, U.S. hero. And last but not least is Arthur's Town. Arthur's Town is in the Bermuda Triangle. And what is the area code of Arthur's Town, where they make some great beer there? Arthur's Town area code is 242. And if you check out Wikipedia about the number 42 and something, I forget, the galaxy or something, you know, an extraordinary story about the galaxies and number 42, which was made into a movie, and I recommend that you see that when you get a chance. Anyway, we want to wish Mr. Nelson Fregelli a very happy birthday. He's 74, and we pray and hope that Almighty God will have mercy on us, will have mercy on France, because the French are undergoing a terrible crisis, as well as the Swedes and Germans and other Europeans who are suffering under this terrible free border policy of George Soros, Hillary Clinton, and Angela Merkel, and Barbara Lerner Spector. These globalist bankers, they have allowed these anti-Christian immigrants to come into these countries in Europe to do away with Christian civilization, to do away with the white race. It's a racism. This is communist-inspired racism of the worst kind, and also anti-Christianism. And we pray and hope that Almighty God replace Francis with somebody holy who will take the name of Pius the 13th. And we noticed that the HBO series, The Young Pope, in which Jude Law played Pope Pius the 13th, is no longer available on HBO for some reason. Anyway, Pope St. Pius the 10th did say that he would have a successor with his name that would be captured and put to death in a very cruel manner in the future, in the end times. And Pius the 11th was not, and Pius the 12th was not. And so we conclude that he was talking about Pius the 13th, who is yet to come. And so the next pope, if he takes the name of Pius the 13th, if he does that, it's with the expectation that he's going to die a martyr's death, because that's how terrible the crisis is in the Holy Catholic Church now, where Francis, a communist, excommunicated himself through Amoris Laetitia. Es una vergüenza, santidad. Usted está excomunicado a través de los enseñamientos de Santo Roberto Berlamino, jesuita y doctor de la Iglesia Católica Apostólica Romana. Él dice que es posible un papa hereje y usted es un hereje. Yo digo, es porque usted escribió Amoris Laetitia y no respondió a los cuatro cardenales que pidieron a su santidad una respuesta escrita sobre la dubia que ellos tienen sobre Amoris Laetitia. Entonces, con todo respeto, no puedo te llamar más papa. Usted no es más papa, es Francisco. Una vergüenza, y usted tiene tiempo para arrepentirse. You have time to repent. All of us can repent. And that's why I have the words there, repent. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. We all have time to repent. And I take this opportunity to thank God for the access that he has given me to the sacraments locally here. I can go to confession in many, many different churches. I can go to Mass every day. And we Catholics should take advantage of this and pray the rosary constantly. It was the rosary that saved President Donald Trump. The America Needs Fatima campaign, over 16,000 rosary rallies on the 15th of October, prayed for America. I was in one of those rallies here in Miami. Each rally had anywhere from 10 to 100 people across America. We prayed the rosary for America on the 15th of October. And all these millions of Hail Marys stormed heaven, and God responded through Our Lady and allowed Mr. Donald John Trump to win 306 electoral votes, even though Hillary Rodham Clinton got maybe a million and a half illegal aliens voting for her. And we asked that President Trump call for an investigation of the massive voter fraud that has taken place for the elections of 2008 and 2012 and also 2016. That had been perpetrated by Democrats, much more than the Republicans. And the Democrats, they are way, way left. They are progressivists. They don't believe in original sin. They, just like the Muslims, believe the end justifies the means. You can lie through your teeth because we're after such and such goals. And if you stand in the way of those goals, we can lie to you until we get our goals. And that's how they think. And it's outrageous. And now Americans have died. 60 million unborn Americans have been aborted. And some 2.5 billion people have died because 8 popes disobeyed God. And of that 2.5 billion that died, 2 billion died through abortion. And 500 million through communism in China, communism in Russia, communism in Vietnam, communism in Cambodia, and communism in many, many other places, and socialism. And we ask God to have mercy on the Venezuelan people. El pueblo de Venezuela está sufriendo una cosa terrible. And we denounce Nicolás Maduro. Usted es un dictador sin vergüenza. Su pueblo está con hambre. Están muriendo de hambre en la calle. Millares y millares de venezolanos, los niños en los hospitales no tienen medicina. La muerte en Venezuela es una vergüenza. Y Venezuela es el país más rico de América Latina. Tiene más petróleo en Venezuela que la Arabia Saudita. More oil reserves in Venezuela than Saudi Arabia. And yet socialism is killing Venezuela. And the progressive socialist cabal that runs the Democratic Party and that run the bankers and all that, they will not give the time of day to report on the terrible tragedy that's happening in Venezuela. And shame on the New York Times, and shame on the Washington Post, and shame on ABC, CBS, NBC, MSNBC for not telling the truth about what's happening in Venezuela. Shame on you! And shame on you, Francis, for not condemning Nicolas Maduro, for not excommunicating him and all those tyrants in South and Central America that have so oppressed their people, but especially in Venezuela today. And also, shame on you for not excommunicating Raul Castro or Fidel Castro while he was alive. I could go on and on, but I'm not going to. Again, my condolences to Mr. John Russell Spann. He was instrumental in my going to New York in August of 1972. That article that I read to you before about Mr. Nelson and myself, that was in July of 72, and it was Mr. John Russell Spann who called me from New York City and invited me to join him and a small group there. And we lived in a very small apartment right across from Rockefeller University on the east side of Manhattan. And that's where the nucleus of the future American Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, Property was born. And one of the first major things that we did was we posed for a photograph in front of the United Nations. And the five of us, I was holding the standard, and two of my friends to my left and two of my friends to my right, Mr. John Hart, John Spann, Philip Calder, and Tim Reese, and myself. And that photograph became a tremendous success because it became a calendar. It became a calendar for the Brazilian Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property. It became their 1973 calendar, which they distributed all over Brazil through their anti-communist caravans up and across the state in the millions. And many were the campaigns, and many are the campaigns pro-life against communism. And we take this opportunity again to say shame, shame on Francis for not condemning China for their persecution of the true Catholic Church, the underground church, and not coming to the support of the Catholics in China. Shame on you, vergüenza! I have to watch it. I want to live longer. I thought yesterday was my last day because my father and Arthur, he died at the age of 74. And my grandfather, another Arthur, he died at the age of 74. And we have the same name, Arthur Leighton Denchfield Sr., MD, born in Brampton, Canada, died in New Jersey and buried in Connecticut. And he died on the 13th of May, 1955, God bless him. And then my father, Arthur Leighton Denchfield Jr., born in New York City in 1906. He died in 1981 here in Coral Gables. And then there's Arthur Leighton Denchfield III, and that's me. And I figured, well, maybe I'm supposed to die too before I turn 75. And I'm not dead, I'm alive. So apparently God wants me to live a little longer. But with my name, I'm a Denchfield III. Well, what is Denchfield III? That's right. Denchfield III is trident. You mean the trident nuclear intercontinental ballistic missile from our submarine fleet of the Royal British Navy and the U.S. Navy? Yes, that's the trident system. But here's another trident right here. This is the coat of arms of Ukraine, the trident, right above the crown of Our Lady Fatima. And why do I have that there? Because the Ukrainians, they suffered. They were the first people to suffer a major catastrophe because of the disobedience of the Pope for the 1929 message. Pius XI should have consecrated Russia to the Immaculate Heart of Mary in 1930. He didn't. And eight popes have disobeyed God, and some 2.5 billion people have died. And that includes 2 billion abortions, 500 million through all the other things that have happened since